Hello, I'm Dan Fox and this is Nick Catlin. We're both members of Team GB and we're here today to talk you through short corners and a few other bits of hockey.
The first stage of the penalty corner is the injection. The intention is to get the ball from here to the top of the circle as quickly as possible. Do it like this, so you line your feet up parallel with the target, nice and low, stick head behind the ball, and then you just drag it from your back foot to your front foot as quickly as you can.
The second part of the penalty corner is to trap the ball as quickly as possible. It has to leave the D before you can have a shot.
The third element of a penalty corner is the shot at goal. Most of the time in men's hockey, this takes the form of a drag flick. With a drag flick, you can put it in the air as well as along the ground. And with a hit, you can only hit the backboard. A lot of people go for the drag flick, and it looks something a little bit like this.
That's the attacking side of penalty corners. I'm just going to talk you briefly through the defensive side. Each team's allowed four defenders and the goalkeeper behind the line at penalty corners. The two most important roles are the number one runner, who tries to get to the top of the D as quickly as possible and block the shot, and the guy who stands on the line and covers the left-hand side of the goal, whilst the keeper covers the right-hand side. For the number one runner, the key idea is as soon as the ball is injected, you have to try and get to the top of the D as quickly as you can. And basically, the braver the number one runner, the tighter the line they'll run. At the same time, the postman will be standing on the line trying to block anything that gets past you, and the keeper normally covers the other two-thirds of the goal.
So that was a lowdown on penalty corner attack and defence. I hope you enjoyed watching and you should definitely get involved in hockey in the future. It's a great sport. Enjoy.